Hello, you 4 knight f64, 6 knight c3, bishop b4 is 3 castles, knight g2, d5, a3, bishop d6, and now let's talk about c5. We play bishop 7. Yes, we spent one tempo, but we provoked this pawn to move to c5. Now we want to strike with b6, and if white plays, before we want to strike with a5. G3 is possible, but see no reason. C6, b4, knight bd7, bishop g2, b6, castles, and bishop a6, and that's the problem because bishop is now active on this diagonal. Rook e1, bc, bc, and e5, standard break. Queen a4, queen c8, bishop h3, and e4, and pawn has no problems like in the game between two engines. So, before the move, and I think that you should start with b6 because in some lines you can bring your knight to c6. If for example now bishop b2, then a5 and knight f4 is transposition. So really two setups for white, with the knight on g3 or with the knight on f4. Let's start with knight g3. So in the setup, white wants to play for f5 at some point, or e4, but I think e4 is harmless. We play a5, and now white should choose what to do. If rook b1, my game went c6, but I think that the easiest move is ab. But let's see what was my game. C6. Bishop d3, bishop a6, castles, bishop d3, queen d3, ab, ab. That was game Savovchuk Punin in the tournament where I made my national master norm. And here I misplayed. The best move was knight bd7. What's the point? White cannot play b5 now because bc, bc, and c4 and black is just much better. And if f3, then we play g6. Protecting the f5 square, and we want to play e5. Bishop d2, e5, and black has no problems. But the easiest solution in such position is to play ab, ab, bc, bc, knight c6, and black wants to play bishop a6 and bring knight to the c4 square. For example, bishop b5, knight a5, castles, and bishop a6. And black has no problems, only white can be worse in such position because white has this bishop. Other moves, bishop d2. Bishop b2 is harmless, so let's talk about bishop d2. We play c6 now. If knight a4, then knight bd7, cb, ab, ab, and bishop a6, and changing the bishops. Sutkovich Yakovlevich game. If bishop e2, then bishop a6, castles, knight bd7, queen c2, queen c7, rook fc1, queen b7, rook ab1, ab, ab, rook fc8, h3, and the draw was agreed in Ivan Sakhov against Michael Adams game. So, harmless white for white. Of course, white can start with bishop d2, we play c6, and now knight f4, or knight c1, or knight g3, but we saw already what to do against knight g3. So, knight c1, bc, bc, and of course we play e5, because white cannot do anything about it. If f3, like in the game Volkov against Filipov here, but should have played ed, ed, and knight h5 with no problems for black. If queen a4, then ed, ed, and bishop c5 is actually a good move because white has some problems after dc d4, because if knight 3 e2, then rook e8 with threat d3, bishop a5, queen d5, king d1, d3, knight c3, queen h5, f3, and knight h6. So bishop e2, dc, bishop c3, and knight d5, and black has no problems now. But okay, knight f4, bc, bc, here black plays e5, d knight fd7, knight a4, knight xe5, bishop c3, and queen c7 with an equal position like in the Ruslan Ponomarev against Judit Polgar game from Vacancy 2003. Knight f4 maybe it's the main move. We play a5, now bishop d2 or bishop b2. Bishop b2, we play c6, if bishop d3, knight bd7, castles, queen c7, knight fe2, and bishop a6, like in the Sochko against Sarkisian game. If bishop e2, the knight bd7, castles, and queen c7, and f3. That's the more white's idea, because if knight d3, then bishop a6, if queen c2, rook e8, knight d3, we wait for bishop for knight d3 and we play bishop a6, f4, rook eb8, like in post the under game is equal position. So bishop e2, knight bd7, castles, and queen c7, and here f3. We play bishop a6, bishop a6, rook a6, queen e2, rook f8, and knight d3, and we just exchange everything. AB, rook a1, rook a1, rook a1, bishop a1, and b7 with an equal position. If rook b1 now, we saw similar idea already. AB, bc, bc, and we play knight c6. The idea of playing knight a5. Bishop b5, knight a5, castles, bishop a6, bishop a6, rook a6 with an equal position. Bocharov against Saparin. So, bishop d2 is the main move. We play c6 now. And if knight a4, then bc, knight c5. Here, black should have played knight bd7, knight d7, bishop d7, b takes a5, because black has this knight a4 move, bishop b4, and of course, we can play e5, d and c5, but even better to play rook takes a5, because white really can take knight a5, bishop d3, bishop b4, ab, rook a1, queen a1, and queen a7 with an equal position. Bishop e2, bishop a6. In Yusupov of Ardanescu game, white played knight d3, knight bd7, castles, bishop c4, queen c2, queen c7, rook fb1, ab, and queen b7 with an equal position. If castles, then knight bd7, bishop a6, rook a6, knight d3, Grachov Romanov. Here black should have played knight e4. New idea. Of course, white should not take on e4, because then black gets this beautiful d5 square. Bishop e1, knight c3, bishop c3, and rook c7 with the standard ideas, rook b8, and ab, no problems for black. And if cb, then knight b6, ba, and knight c4 with an equal position. f3, queen c7, queen c2, bishop e2, knight c2, rook a7, knight d3. That was Evgeny Tobashevsky against Dmitry Kovenga game. Here black should have played rook f8, bishop c3, knight e8, rook fb1, ab, and bishop g5, and black is no problem. So let's make some conclusions. That's very easy line to play for both sides. Black wants to play b6, a5, then maybe c6, maybe knight c6, then bishop a6, exchanging everything. Then knight bd7, rook goes to a6, rook goes to a8, and takes on b4, and all rooks are gone from the board, and we have drawish position. Yes, that might be not the most exciting line in the opening theory, but I think that the g2 is very solid setup for white, so you should go d5 and you should play for the equality and not make some aggressive tries. That's all about so-called Reshevsky system, and in the next videos we will talk about the main move bishop d3, but this system with knight g2 is very poisonous, so I hope you will take the ideas from these two videos in your future games. Thanks for watching this video, and see you again soon. Goodbye.